Pastor, Pastor Chris to share this morning. Just this morning, I was notified that jail administrator Fred Boyce has passed away. He was jail administrator for numerous amount of years. So I asked Chris if you would mind remembering Fred, who was part of his family, this morning.
Dear Father, we just thank you for this day, Lord. We just thank you for another wonderful opportunity, Lord, to gather together, Lord, to remember all of these. Remember Jesus Christ's family, Lord, Fred, family, God, and
Alan Matthew Ragsdale. End of watch, Monday, November 27, 2000. Officer Ragsdale was shot and killed responding to a silent burglary alarm at a local motorcycle dealership. Officer Ragsdale had parked his cruiser in the rear of the building and had walked around the entire building to verify all the doors were secured. As he walked past the door front, he spotted the suspect who immediately fired three shots, striking Officer Ragsdale once. The round struck him in the armpit area where his vest did not offer protection. Officer Ragsdale was flown to a Nashville hospital where he succumbed to his injuries. The 18-year-old suspect fled the scene when other officers arrived, but was captured later in the day and charged with first-degree murder, attempted first-degree murder, and burglary. On August 23, 2002, the suspect pled guilty to murder and was sentenced to life in prison without the possibility of parole. Officer Ragsdale had been an officer with the Hohenwald Police Department for 18 months and survived by his wife, son, and two stepchildren.
Lawrence David Bromley, Senior Corporal, Dallas Police Department, Texas. End of watch, Wednesday, December 11, 1991. Senior Corporal Lawrence Bromley was accidentally shot and killed by other officers during an undercover drug operation. He was an undercover narcotics agent for over 2 years. He was purchasing narcotics from a suspect when a man pulled out a pistol. Responding officers mistook Corporal Bromley for a suspect and shot him with a police shotgun. Corporal Bromley had been with the agency for 10 years. He was survived by his wife and parents.
Luke Hinson, Deputy Sheriff, Lewis County Sheriff's Department. End of watch, Thursday, May 15th, 1930. Deputy Luke Hinson and Deputy Mark Newton of the Lawrence County Sheriff's Department were shot and killed as they raided a steel in Lewis County. The group of raiders were fired upon as they approached the steel. Deputy Hinson, Deputy Newton, who were in the front of the group, were both shot. Deputy Newton was killed instantly. Deputy Hinson was taken to a hospital in Columbia where he succumbed to his wounds the following day. Before he died, Deputy Hinson was able to identify one of the shooters. The man, along with three other men, were arrested and charged with both murders. Deputy Hinson was survived by his wife, three young children, parents, 10 brothers, and 3 sisters.
I want to give you a little bit of history of our Alan Ragsdale Memorial Award. We started doing this, I can't remember how many years ago. It's been several years ago that we've been doing this. I know Ms. Joan Cothran was the first one that we present this award with. And each year we talk about who we feel has been certainly a help and has supported law enforcement. And there's usually many candidates to choose from in our own community. And unfortunately, as we talked about this year, this is our first time that we're remembering someone that has went on to be with the Lord already. And before we present this award, this man, Don Jones, was full of life. Many of you knew Don. Not only did I have the opportunity to call him my boss, but I had the opportunity to call him a friend. And I tell you, if you didn't know him, you missed a smile, because Don was sure a great guy. So I did not feel that I could do justice making those comments, but I have asked three men that were what I believe some of his closest friends, and one happens to be our mayor, and one happens to be superintendent of schools, and one just happens to be a great guy. So not that you other two aren't great guys. That's not at all what I meant or implied. So I'm going to ask our mayor, Danny McKnight, our superintendent of schools, Mr. Pace, and Tom Repetto, if they wouldn't mind coming to talk about their very good friend and our ex-mayor and a friend to a lot of us, is who we're going to give that award in his memory this year. Mayor.
I know when you see a packet like this, you think, oh, this is going to be a while, but I'll be as brief as possible. And before I get into this, though, I've noticed, you know, we're talking about giving a few thanks and what have you. And I've noticed out there we've got some former policemen, people who are on the force and things of that nature. If you are a former policeman or if you're a policeman right now working someplace else or whatever, will you please stand up? Mike, I'm talking to you. That's what I'm talking about. Will y'all give them a round of applause? 1962, President John F. Kennedy signed a proclamation which designated May 15th as Peace Officers Memorial Day and the week in which that day falls as Police Week. Blue ribbons are attached to vehicles to show your support of Police Week and for law enforcement officers that have made the ultimate sacrifice for their communities. 144 officers died in the line of duty in 2018. That's sad to say, but true. Fallen officers from our community that we are honoring today, Officer Alan Ragsdale, today our thoughts and love go to Shelly and Aaron. We love you. Senior Corporal David Bromley, who, you talk about connections and everything, David, Larry, what we call him, Larry Bromley, me and him sack groceries. For those of you who remember, at Chandler's Food Town, we worked together sacking groceries. So when you look at all these things, one way or another, we're all connected, and it's still that way. And of course, Deputy Sheriff Luke Hinson, we could stand here all day and pay tribute to these men, and that still wouldn't begin to cover our love and appreciation for these and for these heroic individuals. Personally, in addition to paying tribute to these local heroes that have given their all and paid the ultimate sacrifice for us, at this time I would also like to show my gratitude by honoring and acknowledging everyone that plays a part in keeping us safe in this great community of ours. Like I said, I'm going to try to keep this as brief as possible, but I think this is necessary at this time. Our police officers and personnel, Mackenzie Carroll, Sam Livingston, Kevin Carroll, Earl Taylor, Larry Joe Henson, David Henley, Kip Kelsey, James Howard, Shane McKnight, Robert Francis, Clay Cobb, Marshall Runyons, Chris Hines, Jordan Alkire, Shane Lowry, Brandon Gray, Caleb Halfacre, Tommy Barber, Brent Bridges, Alex Haley, Bucky Isbell, Tommy Taylor, Carolyn McDonald. That's our police department. Dispatch, Twyla Pig, Jack McVickers, Ginger Kilpatrick, Mandy Lindsay, Michelle Stevens, Patrick Baxter, Taylor Darby. Dispatch. Fire department and first responders, Steve Vineyard, Terry Cobbin, Randy Henson, Ryan Johnson, Rodney Henson, Tommy Barber, Darren Passo, Aaron Henson, Ron Johnson, Brad Lawson, Dustin Carroll, Stephen Lau, Dale Baker, Jim Williams, Barry Churchill, Carson Bay, Doug Vineyard, Josh Burns, Michael Dunn, James Walker, Tim Tanner, Caleb Owen, Darrell Newport, Hewlin Dunn, James Howard, Ty Seaver, Jonathan Sparks, Ty Hadley, Brad Raspberry, Richard Duval, Mike Zimmerman. Simply put, thank you all for all you do, and please give me all these guys. This is not scripted. Last year when I spoke here, I told the story. It was a kind of a humorous story about the case, the cold case here in Hohenwald, the missing piano from the Church of Christ. Today I'm not going to tell a humor story. We got Tom Repetto and Benny Pace, who's going to be talking a little bit about our friend Don, who was, you know, he was a former policeman and also a mayor, city mayor here. I will say that, and we were talking about, I think me and Tom were talking about this sometime this week, but now Don, if he could go someplace and buy a buck knife for 50 cents, and sell it to David Henley for $25, that made him feel so great. And it wasn't the money thing, it was just the idea that he got to clip David Henley. So all of us that were his friends, if he got an opportunity to stick it to us, he was going to. Which of course with me, sometimes he'd try that and he'd say, I got a deal for you right here. I'll give you this right here for this amount of money. I can't give this to anybody else. And I'd say, Don, you must have forgot I was with you when you bought it. So, but with that being said, this is what I'm going to say about my friend. his number one agenda. Really, the only thing he actually cared about as far as like he what he felt like inside. And I know this is like a cliche, and it's certainly not original, but you know, you talk about looking in the dictionary for something. And if you look in the dictionary and you wish to see Don's picture, the only definition would be there. Don lived to love others and for others to love him. So when you look in the dictionary under the word love, it's Don Jones. I'll leave it at that. Thank you.
Appreciate the opportunity to address this group and a group of those whom I greatly admire and hold in high esteem, and that's you, the members of law enforcement. I really, really appreciate you and honor those who've served before and those who've gone, who gave all in their service, who've been mentioned here today. And my association with this event, of course, is in particular is my friend and former police officer, former mayor, former building inspector, former this, former that, Don Jones, who I love. And there are a few people here. Are there some people here that worked with Don still on the police department? I know. Yeah, there we go. I knew Steve did. You didn't have that opportunity. A lot of you may not even know that he was a police officer. But if you didn't have that opportunity to be around him much, you missed a great, great time with Don. The community and the world that you, police officers and deputies and state troopers and everybody else that has to deal in law enforcement, that you live in and serve is so much different from the world that Don knew as a police officer, as we all knew how times were back then. He did his job the same way he did everything, with a sense of dedication, love for his fellow man, and he had a lot of fun, without question. Which is how we all should tackle it, I think. Back then, you knew most of the people you were confronted with on a given day if you were in law enforcement. Most times, disputes were settled out back, where the worst of it, maybe someone having a black eye or a fat lip. You know, that's how things were handled most often then. And often it was followed by a handshake. Anybody else remember those days? Different time. It wasn't hard to guess who you're probably going to have a problem with on a late Saturday night. And through it all, we were a community with small town values, a connection with one another, and Don loved it. But I want to go a little further and talk about today's officers too. Today's world is a place where, in so many cases, law enforcement is being ostracized. A universal media world where small town USA is no longer shielded by geography or distance. It's hard to understand or grasp the reality of the horrible atrocities we've seen in schools across the nation since Don was a police officer, since those days. SROs, God bless you. God bless you. You're the first line of defense, and you protect our most precious possessions, and that's our children and grandchildren. Who would have dreamed that we would live in a day when churches would need armed security during worship? Never thought I'd see that day. You'll come in contact with those whom life has little value and God is never mentioned. Law enforcement officers are targets by simply wearing the uniform or as part of a gang initiation, and that's a given even before the shift begins. You see, the very worst in people, and sometimes the very best. Most of the time it's the very worst in your situation. I know it wears on you. There's always hope for the future, though, when there are people willing to take on these challenges like yourself. We have something that so many we hear about don't have. We have this special community that, for the most part, still holds to the core values and ideals that those before us held firm. We've got our problems. Sure, we've got our problems. As with any job, and addressing the officers, as with any job or career, there will always be differences, arguments, and contention. But you are a brotherhood, and you're able to put aside petty differences when it matters. And you're also so fortunate to have an administration who cares and cares about you. It's been said if you love what you do, you will never work a day in your life. I hope you love what you do because it matters. I hope you all realize what an important part you play in our community and its strength. And you are ambassadors in this community. If Don were here, he would be the first to applaud you, the first to help you in any way he could, and I promise you, the first to pray for you and your safety. John 15:13 says, greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. Thank you to all who protect and serve, and those who have paid the ultimate price, those who worked before in law enforcement. Thank you so much. And thank you, wives, husbands, and families who you choose to let share with us. God bless you all. Thank you.
I didn't write anything down, but they asked me to come talk about Don as the evening. I'll have to. They said about 5 minutes. I'll try to go less than that. I knew Don Jones better than anybody. Better than anybody in this world, I knew him. And I'm not over it. I'm not over him being gone. Quit. And so to get up and talk about it is an honor. I appreciate it. I can tell you things about Don that nobody knew. Once you got to know him, you started seeing some things about Don. For one thing, Don Jones was who he was, no matter where he was at, what job he had, who he was talking to, it didn't matter. He was Don Jones. If he could wear a hat, cock back on his head, put a different skull in his mouth, he was going to. And if it got bored, he was going to fall asleep. I've seen him fall asleep on the bus truck, and many of you have too. He didn't apologize for that. And he absolutely was a genius. He truly was. If you ever was in Don, with Don in any situation where true thinking was involved, he was brilliant. And it took me a little while to really be convinced of that. He's in top 10 of his class, and just absolutely brilliant. He had a recall of numbers like I wish I had. He proved it to me one day because he was always showing off what he could. This, I said, this, that, I said, much. Well, I'm pretty good at math, but I can't do that. So I took the grocery list in our early friendship. I took the grocery list and read it. 69 cents, 49 cents, $22, 57 cents, and went all the way down. When you got to the end and said the last number, he could tell you how much that was. That's a smart man. I don't care if it's a grocery list or what it is. That was Don Jones. I know about his careers and the things he's done, and I also know what he was passionate about. He loved Lewis County, but I'm going to tell you, he really loved Hohenwald. He loved Hohenwald. He wanted to serve Hohenwald. He loved politics, but he found out that he hated being a politician. If you know him, Don was a good mayor. He hated it. I hate to stand up here in front of you and tell you that. He did not like it. Because Don Jones loved everybody. And he honestly thought, if you treat people right, they'll love you back. And when you're in a political job, many can attest to that. I'm one of them. Sometimes you have to make hard decisions. People don't like you over it. That, Don couldn't understand that. He couldn't understand it because he loved people. You know, he operated through love. He was hopelessly, hopelessly dedicated to his family. You know, his mom and his aunt. You know, he knew when he's younger. You know, everything revolved around them. But the many things that he'd done in life, I was a part of. I was kind of there. I was a side saddle, I guess. Being a police officer, he thoroughly enjoyed that. He really did, because he could help people. You know, when you're in trouble, I was taught as a poor young boy over in Sycamore Center, something's going on, get a police officer hit you. And I was raised like that. And many of us in the small town, Hohenwald, Tennessee, was. Thank God. And I still feel like that. And Don felt that like that. He could help people. If I'm a police officer and somebody needs something, I can help them. And he enjoyed that part of the job. Now, I got stories I can't tell. I was told not to tell because he broke some of the rules. That was a different time. And the statute of limitation, and Don's not here with us more, so I think, you know, most of that's okay now. One thing was, I was dating Jen. We've been married 33 years now, but I was dating her, and I come from her house, and Don worked, if he ever worked late, and I got blue lights. After the first time I knew it, I wasn't in trouble, but he pulled me over. We'd stop at the airport and talk. Blue lights. I'd have to make the blue lights off. But I don't think he's supposed to be pulling people over just to pull over at the airport and talk to them. And occasionally, there was once or twice I got in with him and we rode around at midnight. So, you know, I kind of was a police officer. Well, it's not. I wonder what would have happened if something would have been. He'd been called somewhere. He'd probably dropped me off the side of the road. But that never happened. But he loved his community. He acted like that. And throughout his life, he dispatched. You know, that was still a part of being a police officer. You know, he was in on it. You know, he could make sure that you're at honor. Somebody was sent here, Stevens sent here. You know, he could take care of people. Call him. What was he calling for? Help. Help. When he was mayor, he wanted to help people. We can help people. We can help people. So, you know, if I had to describe him in one way, that's what he'd be. He loved people. He loved to help. He loved being loved. He loved loving, and he loved being loved. And I tell you, he made a great impact on my life. He was a older brother to me. I was his best man, and he was my best man. And that's the way it was. And that describes our relationship. And I want you to know, if you ever was a part of anything he was doing, he loved doing it. He was sincere. He truly was. Work as a community. There'll never be another Don Dawg. Never. And as a community, I think we're fortunate that we were able to kind of have a little brush in his events and his shenanigans, too. Because he was a funny, funny man. I'm going to tell you, he get me laughing quicker than anybody. But I appreciate everything that the city's doing. I appreciate this honor for Don. I also appreciate our police officers, our dispatchers, and fire department, and everybody that's in a service-oriented job. It's not easy. It's not easy. Hey, having good intentions, sometimes to some people is not enough. You can have good intentions and really have your heart to help them, and it's not always enough. These police officers have to deal with it every day. I admire it. It's a job I wouldn't want, just to be honest with you, because it's tough. So thank everybody for coming. Thank all the police officers in the city, Mayor Matt Knight, for Chief Liz for tuning in. And if you get a chance to talk to somebody about Don and you know him, and you really know him, do it. That's what I've been telling people. Because if we keep his memory alive, he's not gone. In fear. So I do it all the time. So you won't have a big conversation with me about anything. Let me mention my friend. Thank you.
Ragsdale Memorial Award presented in memory of Donald Ray Jones on this 16th day of May 2019. For your caring contribution to law enforcement and the citizens of Hohenwald, the years of dedicated service will never be forgotten. From the City of Hohenwald Police Department, citizens of Hohenwald, Lewis County, and Lewis County Sheriff's Department, Don served as a law enforcement officer and dispatcher from 1978 to 1983. He was a building inspector from 1996 to 2003. And our city mayor from 2007 to
you always get a bouquet of flowers. Is there anyone here from Deputy Hinson's family that we can present these to? We're going to continue to get them every year, hoping that maybe someone will be here. What about Corporal Bromley's family? Continue to remember Miss Bromley. She's not able to join us anymore. She did as long as she could, but continue to remember her. And I just want to thank you all for being here. And our prayers are with you as they are each and every day. So I noticed that I changed the program around too and didn't mean to. The presentation where we're supposed to be before the main speakers. That's not how it happened. Sorry. I'm going to ask, we've got a few things left in our program today. We're going to have a video in just a second that we're going to watch. And I'm going to change something around too. I'm going to ask Pastor Bean if you wouldn't mind maybe after video. And there's going to be something after the video. Well, no, come on up now. I'm keeping it. We had this for a reason. I guess I'll not change it. But my daughter normally sings a song that she wrote for several years, and I knew one of these years that she got poor that she probably would not be able to make it, and that year is this year. So she was not able to be here with us this year. But we've chosen a last call. It's a video that we're going to watch. And I told Shelly, you know, I was saying something to some of the guys. As I first watched this video, my wife and I were looking at them. I said, absolutely not. That's way too emotional for me to see this video. I don't want to watch that. But then as we watched other videos, I said, you know, that is what this day is about. It's about remembering those who have lost their lives in the line of duty. And the last call is exactly what you would think it's about. That is what it's about. It's about an officer's last call. And I just want to tell you that I've let several officers watch it, and I could tell their reaction was the same as mine. And then I thought for a second, I said, you know what? Sometimes you see things like this, and it reminds you that we're not supermen. We don't fly around with a cape. We are mortal like everybody else, but you know what? And every officer that I ask the same thing after I see that, we see this movie kind of gets you emotional. It kind of makes you realize that that could happen to any single one of us any given day. But you know what, if the call came out right now, we'd go towards those bullets just like we would any other time, because that's who we are. It takes a special person to be a police officer. It doesn't matter who you work for, we're all police officers, and it takes a special person. And I can't thank enough for all the police officers in our community, because I hope, and I can tell you, I want to thank you as a community, because we don't experience in this community what many communities do. We are thanked all the time for the job. You know, I know Mike and Gary and Larry, some of these guys have retired. It's a community like no other that we're thanked all the time. We're appreciated in our community. I can tell you, you don't know how much we appreciate that. You don't know how much we appreciate it. So Pastor Chris is going to close for us with some remarks of the prayer. We're going to watch this video. Then we're going to have a 21-gun salute and then taps, and then we'll play bagpipes, and that will be the end of our service.
Thank you for the opportunity. Sam asked me a couple weeks ago to speak at this, and I really tried to figure out what to say. I come across this scripture in Matthew chapter 5. It says, "Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God." And there was some writing along with it, and I wanted to read this, and then I'll pray. It says, "A peacemaker is willing to give up his perceived rights as he pursues a path of seeking and advancing harmony among other individuals, families, and nations, so that they may experience peace through God's love. We can become that kind of peacemaker if we're willing to walk in step with Him, that is Christ, and allow the Holy Spirit to empower us and pour the love of God into our hearts. You know, this week and every week, we must never forget the courage that law enforcement has and the families that back them up. You know, it's a definite struggle, and we're definitely blessed in this community to have great people that are willing, as Sam said, whenever the bullets are flying, they'll run right in the middle of it for you, for us. And that's, I want to thank them for that, for our community, that we have such great people. Dear Father, we just thank you once again for the opportunity, Lord, to be a part of your kingdom, Lord, and a part of this community, Lord. We thank you for these people, Lord, for our police officers, Lord, those that have gone before, those that are still serving, Lord. We pray that you just watch over our community. We pray that you just divinely lead and guide every one of them. Keep them safe as they go about their job. And just bless this community in your mighty, wonderful name.
Thank you.
so much for each and every person being here today. We've never done this before, but we're going to do something a little different. If you are a family member of an officer that's here today, would you get up and get by that family member? If you're a family member, that means husband, wife, children, parents, grandparents. Go ahead and get by that officer. Deputy, whoever it might be. DA's investigator will take you off. Very much for